So when I say genetics has a lot to do with it, guess what? That's luck, because we all know we can't actually choose our own parents unless you're on HRT, and then you can do anything. Coach Greg, and today I'm going over a video by Veritasium. The video is called, Is Success Luck or Hard Work? I know most of us want to think it's all because of our hard work. It's because we're working harder than last time. But is it really the hard work we're doing, or are we just getting lucky? I've already watched the video. It's a very good video. I'm going to watch it again. I'm going to respond and tell you what I think. Do I agree, disagree, and what can I add to it? So hopefully you'll stay tuned, watch, and see what happens.
Take hockey players, for example. If you ask a professional hockey player how they managed to reach the NHL, they might mention their hard work, determination, great coaches, their parents' willingness to get up at 5 a.m., and so on. But they probably won't acknowledge how lucky they were to be born in January. And yet, in many years, 40% of hockey players selected into top-tier leagues are born in the first quarter of the year, compared to just 10% in the fourth quarter.
So isn't it interesting? Of course, the hockey players are quickly going to say, yeah, you know, I trained so hard, I worked so hard for it, and I woke up early, and my parents, of course, they helped me out. But what about sheer luck? The month that they're born literally is a huge impact on their success in their career. But you're thinking, why? Well, think about it. If you're born in January, you get to be the older one in the class. You get to stand out. You're bigger, faster, taller, whatever. That gives you a competitive advantage over the other players. You get more attention. They notice you more. And that luck leads to your success. Of course, the hard work helps too. But without the luck, would you have been able to do it? I was born in September, and when I went to school, I was the youngest one in the class. I was 4 years old. All my friends are five, so I'm smaller, shorter, and that makes me have a disadvantage over everyone else. I'm starting school with some of the kids in my class that are almost a year older than me. They're not only going to be taller, they're probably also going to be smarter. So you start your first day of school, you're at a disadvantage versus the other kids in your class. You're going to seem like you're not so smart, and that can lead to a disadvantage. So just the month that you're born in can lead to an advantage later in life.
An early birthday can make you up to four times as likely to be a pro hockey player.
Just think of it, four times more likely to be a pro hockey player if you're born early in the year than later in the year. Sucks, and I used to play hockey, and guess what? I'm not a professional hockey player, I'm a professional bodybuilder. Maybe if I would have been born in January, I wouldn't be a YouTuber, maybe I'd be playing up some hockey.
Now, as they grow up, this difference should eventually shrink to nothing, but it doesn't. Because the young kids who show the most promise are given more time on the ice and enter more tournaments where they receive better coaching and improve their skills.
Those little stick figures, they're just moving around. It reminds me of Bahij Kajura. You remember this video? He's just standing there. It reminded him, getting vibes of Bahij Kajura. Getting Bahij Kajura vibes.
And these advantages compound year after year. So by the time you get to the pros, birthdays are heavily skewed towards the start of the year. But does any professional hockey player feel thankful for their birthday? Probably not.
Imagine a famous hockey player standing there at the award ceremony saying, I'd like to thank my parents for not having sex in January, February, or March to give me a competitive advantage over my opponents so that I can have a birthday early in January. Can you see this? But it literally is a huge impact. 40% of the players are born in that time, compared to 10% born earlier. So when your parents decide to have sex, it has a dramatic influence on your ability to be a professional athlete later on in the future. You want to call that luck? You know, HRTs travel back in time. Tell your parents when to have sex and when not to have sex. Hey, parents, hold up, use protection here. It's okay, you forgot your condoms. It's okay, it's April. You can go ahead now. Think about it, it literally makes sense to do this.
Probably the most significant bit of luck many of us enjoy is being born into a prosperous country. Around half the variance in income received by people around the world is explained by their country of residence and that country's income distribution. If you were born in Burundi, for example, which has the world's lowest gross national income per capita of just $730 a year, it doesn't matter how smart or hardworking you are, you're unlikely to earn much as an adult.
So think of this, if you make a decent amount of money, you're automatically lucky, because frankly, if you weren't born where you were born, chances of you making the money you're making a lot lower. Okay, so if you have a really good job and you're making a lot of money, kind of like Coach Greg, You can be thankful that you were born in a country that could afford you to do that. If I was born in a really poor country, couldn't afford an iPhone, I couldn't have videotaped myself doing those friggin' rants. Couldn't have uploaded it. I even have a camera now. Think of it. If you can't afford to do this, how can you afford to make more money? Trust me, there is a lot of luck that has to do with your income. Yeah, I work a lot of hours and all that, but I'm also very fortunate. So thank your lucky stars or whatever you want to thank for being born in the country that allows you to have a good life.
Now, many people get offended if you point out how big a role chance plays in their success. And I get it. If we are just a product of our circumstances, then our hard work and our talent seem to count for nothing. People think it has to be either skill or luck that explains success. But the truth is, you need both.
And I get this all the time in bodybuilding. If you tell someone that you look that way because of genetics, no, it's not genetics. I have a horrible genetics. You know, I'm Tom Platz. I have bad genetics. Yeah, okay, Tom Platz. Yeah, you have bad genetics. You're an IBU pro bodybuilder. So when I say genetics has a lot to do with it, guess what? That's luck, because we all know we can't actually choose our own parents unless you're on HRT, and then you can do anything. But for most people, you can't choose your parents. You can't choose the luck that you're born into. I was born with amazing genetics. That's luck. That's one of the main reasons I was able to become a pro bodybuilder. Other people with less fortunate luck, it doesn't matter how hard they work. They can work harder than last time. If they were born with shitty genetics, they just can't get the same physique. So unfortunately, it does have a lot to do with luck if you're born with the right genetics to build the right body to get the physique of your dreams. And setting world records, it has a lot to do with luck. Obviously, if you're running in a tailwind, you're going to run faster than if you're running in a headwind. The headwind, it slows you down. So if you happen to have the world record for running, yeah, obviously you can run pretty friggin' fast, but you're also lucky to have had a tailwind on that day. If you had a headwind, chances are pretty slim that you're gonna be able to set that world record now, isn't it?
Consider the most recent class of NASA astronauts. From over 18,300 applicants in 2017, only 11 were selected and went on to graduate from the astronaut training program. Let's assume that astronauts are selected mostly based on skill, experience, and hard work, but also, say, 5% as a result of luck, fortunate circumstances.
So you want to be an astronaut, and you think it's probably your skill that's going to get you there. Well, guess what? There's tens of thousands of people that are applying for this job as an astronaut. All of them have a lot of skill. So what is the difference? Luck.
And I repeated this simulation 1,000 times, representing 1,000 different astronaut selections. So how many of the selected astronauts would have been in the top 11 based on skill alone? The answer was, on average, only 1.6.
Even if luck is only 5% of the equation, it still encompasses for a huge determining factor on if you get, in fact, selected to be an astronaut or not. You want to think that it's all because of your hard training, the luck and dedication that you did. But you don't want to think that the small amount of luck that has to do with it is a huge proportion when you look at the actual end results.
Being talented and hardworking is important, but it's not enough to guarantee success. You also need to catch a break. Largely, I think we're unaware of our good luck because, by definition, it's not something we did.
And listen, it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's good to think that it's your hard work that's getting you to your goals. If you think it's all luck, well, you're not going to try very hard. You're just going to say, oh, it's all luck. So if you want to become a YouTuber and you think it's all luck, you're just going to make a couple videos and say, well, the algorithm will either like it or it won't. It's nothing I do or don't do. But if you think it's all me, and I'm going to work 100 hours a week like Coach Greg, I'm going to train harder than last time and put out more videos than ever before. If you don't think you have the power to influence this, you're not going to work as hard. So you have to believe in yourself and believe that you can do it. But listen, I'm a very realistic person, and I know that I had a lot of luck to get popular on YouTube. Yeah, I worked hard, I did all the things, but I also had luck. There's millions of YouTubers, and not all of them are going to get a million followers. And it's not just the ones that work the hardest that get the most followings. Some people have amazing quality information, They just don't get lucky and they don't become famous. We don't know why. I don't know why. They just didn't get lucky.
Now, think of what all this means for people in our society, specifically for people in positions of power, like business leaders and politicians. Now, undoubtedly, most of them are talented and hardworking, but they have also been luckier than most. And like most of us, they don't realize just how lucky they are. And this gives them a distorted view of reality. They're kind of living in a form of survivor bias. All these leaders have worked hard and ultimately succeeded, so to them the world appears fair.
So think of the people on this planet with the most power. They've got the most money, the most power, the best jobs, just the best of everything. They're up here. We're over here. We want to work our way up to them. So all of these people, they're extremely successful. They've achieved it all. They've done it all. And of course, they've worked their asses to get there. So in their minds, the people who work the hardest, they're the ones that are going to be most successful. So when they look at other people that maybe they're not up to their level, they're up here. Remember, they're looking down on everybody else. You guys only make this much money. You guys don't do that good. We're up here. You're over there. So when they see other people down below, they're thinking, yeah, they probably never worked hard enough. They never put as much effort as I did. What they're not thinking is that they're just less lucky than them. They might even be better than them, smarter than them, worked harder, did everything appropriately, but we're not as lucky. They're not as fortunate. So when you're up here looking down on people, you can't just think it's because you worked harder. It's also because you got more luck. Luck has a lot to do with it. So what can you do as somebody way up here? You can help bring luck to other people.
It seems a cruel trick of our psychology that successful people without any malice will credit their success largely to their own hard work and ingenuity, and therefore contribute less to maintaining the very circumstances that made that success possible in the first place.
So how does this apply to Coach Greg? Because I'm watching this video and I'm thinking, well, how did luck play to do with my YouTube channel? And I'm thinking, well, I kept posting videos for over 10 years and finally I got some success. It's not like I magically learned something new. Okay, I always knew what I knew. I've always been trying to do the best that I can. And some of the things I posted years ago are exactly what I keep saying today. I've been eating and dieting the same way for years. But it took some kind of luck to be able to be more successful. You know what's really weird? Something might happen to you and you think it's bad luck, but it's actually a blessing in disguise. I lost my school teaching position. I couldn't be a school teacher anymore. Well, that sucks. I'm so unlucky. I did this and did that. And later you find out that because of that, it actually gave you an advantage. If I had kept my school teaching job, do you think I would have been able to do this? No, I wouldn't have been able to do that. So I actually got lucky by being unlucky. If you weren't given the situation or circumstances to force you to try something different, you might not have been able to try out and find out you'd been successful at that thing that you didn't think you'd do in the first place. So everything that's ever happened to you in your entire life can lead to you being successful later on in life. As a personal example, think about how random this is. I'm on YouTube, type in my name in the cookbook and all this stuff, and I come across a video by the Iron Musket, and I'm watching the video. I'm like, yeah, I think I should do a response video. I like this video. I'm going to do a response video. That response video comes across so well that people end up going to the Iron Musket's channel, and his channel becomes more popular, and it also sells my freaking cookbook. I'm lucky because he made the video, so I'm lucky enough to watch his video and discover it, lucky enough to decide to do a video on it, and then that sells the book. People like the cookbook, and it keeps going and spreading. And who knows, if it wasn't for the Iron Musket's video, maybe my book wouldn't be where it is today. We don't know. Okay, so that's the kind of luck that has to do with it. And now Iron Musket's got over 20,000 followers. So Iron Musket, you could say he got lucky by me finding his video, which helped him. Or maybe if I wouldn't have found it, somebody else would have found it and made him even more famous. Who knows? But it just goes to show how luck has something to do with it. But you can't depend on luck. It's luck. You can't expect luck. You have to just work harder than last time, do the best that you can do, and hope that you get lucky. So being a very mathematical person, I think that I can totally agree and accept everything that he's saying, and it's interesting to see it presented this way. So for me, when I look at the success of my career, I know that I worked really hard for it, but I also know that I'm very fortunate to have achieved what I've achieved, and that luck, genetics, all this kind of stuff had a lot to do with it. So why not try to help other people? people, we all need some good fortune, some luck in our lives. So those of you who think that you worked really hard to get where you are, realize you also had a lot of luck. Other people out there are working just as hard as you, but didn't get the luck or fortune that you had to achieve your success. So if you can, try to spread out the luck, try to help other people, end it here. GregDucette.com for coaching, GregDucette IB Pro. We're blooping up to 2 videos. Hopefully I get some luck in the Zwift bike race at 410. I'm in second place, I gotta chase down the winner. Anyway, buy my freaking cookbook, training book, and subscribe to TikTok, Instagram, and so on. And until next time, wish me some luck. I'm out.